A trial date has been set for determining whether or not a Sig Sauer muzzle device is a silencer, like federal regulators say it is, or a muzzle brake, as the company claims. The case between the gunmaker and the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, Firearms and Explosives started its journey towards conclusion in January 2014, when the court asked for final arguments. Sig filed suit in April 2014 after the ATF rejected the company's rebuttal to its determination. The ATF Firearms Technology Branch ruled the muzzle device submitted for review was the internal component for a silencer and not a muzzle brake. Sig introduced the device at the beginning of 2013 at SHOT Show in Las Vegas. The device, a 9.5-inch component welded onto a 6.5-inch barrel, was featured on a pistol-caliber carbine called the Sig MPX. Alone, the device does not reduce the sound of a gunshot, but when fitted with a metal sleeve, it serves as a fully functional silencer, something company reps touted as a selling point during the show.
What's really cool about it is, for those who like quiet guns, you can buy this gun off your shelf, and if you'd like to, this year we start making silencers at Sig Sauer. So we have a silencer specifically developed for this gun. All you do is throw it over the top, and we've got a cap, throw the end cap on there, and now you've got an integral suppressed 9mm little carbine, which is just a dream to shoot.
Some gun rights advocates view the lawsuit as a way to chip away at the federal laws that strictly regulate ownership of items such as silencers. The two-week bench trial will begin August 4th in New Hampshire Federal Court. Pre-trial statements will be due July 1st, and objections are due July 15th. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.